welcome back, guys, to another episode of Indie Closet. Tonight's game is going to be Monastery by Kitty Horror Show. Yes, it's me, and yes, it's been a long time. I'm aware of that. I only really upload content when I'm in a place in my life where I'm not physically and mentally stressed, and as a given, I've been kind of both of those things for the past few years. But luckily, I'm in a better spot in my life now. I'm going to be moving to a new place come March, April, and I'm going to be in a better position to make videos and record for you guys. If you guys have been following any of my other streams, I might have mentioned before that I was kind of mentally and physically stressed out with my job. Well, after a long time of working at McDonald's, I've finally gotten a new job. You might see it right here. I work for security at a Pfizer location, and I basically just sit in a guardhouse all day. It's a pretty neat job, and it's much less physically and mentally taxing than McDonald's. So my brain's all here, guys, and I'm ready to return to what I love. So anyway, all that aside, Kitty Horror Show. She's made quite a few games, you can see here. Like, some of them are paid, most of them are free, though. The one I'm playing is in a Haunted City pack. These are packs of four mini-games that she released to her Patreons, but they're now for free on her website. So, the one I'm going to be playing is from Pack 2, I believe it's this one, and it's Monastery. I don't really know much about that game. I saw a quick YouTube playthrough of it, and I thought that looked really cool. Didn't watch the whole thing, so I don't know anything about it really, but I like the aesthetics of that. Looks pretty cool, looks pretty creepy. All of her games seem to have that PS1 game feel to them, which it's a common trope with indie horror games, but you know, it's a good one. There's a reason why it's popular. So without further ado, let's get this rocking. All right. I lost my spot. Hang on. Indie games, Kitty Horror Show. Whew, yeah, these are all of the ones that are just in that Haunted City series, so there's a million of them. I might play some more of these on my channel. Monastery. Let's go. All right. So it looks like it's got Doom controls. I can rock with that. I'm going to want to change that, though. That's kind of weird camera angle. Let's set that to up to be X, down to be Z, so they're right next to my hands. And other than that, well, we can set reset to S. All right. I mean, honestly, just a setting screen is a welcome with indie games, so... Because as you know, some of the games I've played have just had nothing in terms of options. So it's good to have that. I can actually play this in 1440p without having to go into the text files and edit shit. So that's definitely a bonus. All right, let's play. Oh, shoot. That was fast. I'm right into it. Okay. So it looks like we've got, yep, same controls as Doom, but there's a... mouse cursor I can't seem to get off my screen. I wonder what this is for. Let's stick it to the side for now. There's no sprint, so it's all the same speed. This must be where I came from. Okay. Well, let's explore this place. That's weird. I set space to be my use key. Hang on. Ah! What? Okay, this game has officially the weirdest controls I have ever seen. You open doors by clicking it with a mouse. I mean, hey. Whatever floats the creator's boat, they wanna set it like that. I didn't even see an option for that. It just is what it is. See, press enter to continue, not click. And they've got the up and down thing going for them, too. So yeah, I feel right at home here. This is very doomy. Except for more creepy. More ambient. Hope that mouse cursor in the screen doesn't bother you guys. I'm in the same boat. Okay. There's also no speed multiplier, so I can't sprint by pressing shift like I've been able to in the other games. Both locked. What about this one? What's that? Okay. What's this have to say? So, to put my fingers in or to not put my fingers in? I think I'm going to settle for backing away from that door until I have to come to it. Because that is not something I want to deal with right now. Alright, what do we have here? This looks like some Victorian painting. No info on it. Okay. I gotta say, the graphics are charming. I love these type of graphics. Overused a little, but you know. As I said before, it's overused for a reason. Alright. Locked. Oh, here's one. So this looks like a barracks area. Let me just... See, this is a little awkward. I have to stop every time to click these things. And you have to get pretty close to them to... Oh! Okay, we got a key. Looking good. Chapel. I guess that's where we'll try to find next. What is a chapel, anyway? It's on the tip of my tongue. Reminds me of church, so I'm gonna try to find one of those. Any other of these open? Huh? Nothing in there. Someone's having a restless night. I imagine it wouldn't be easy to sleep in a place like this. Alright, we got two more. Did I already check these? I don't know. Let's try them anyway. Oh. Nothing. Okay. Well, that's that. Alright. What is this? You know it's been long when they use the word four times. Okay. Well, I hope Mother stays away from me, because I got one already. I don't need any creepy ones. Ugh, I wonder if this is the type of game to have enemies in it. That's... I hope not. I'm a massive pussy with horror games right now. After playing them for a while, your tolerance for them goes up, but I haven't played horror games in a... What is that? What is that? As I was saying, I haven't played horror games in a long time. It sounded like it was... Oh, okay. So, yeah, I don't know exactly where that noise came from. I think that's where I spawned. Let's try to find a chapel, since this is the outside area. You know what I really miss, since this has Doom controls? Being able to strafe left and right. This one doesn't have any options for that. Huh. Let me just make sure I'm not missing anything outside before I go back in. Because maybe there's something that's off the straight and narrow. I'm gonna shit my pants if I find something out here. Genuinely. That will not be okay. That's not okay. That's not allowed. Don't do it. Alright. See, yeah, it looks like that's all there is out here. Let me... Okay. Is that Mother? Okay. Well, I'm going to be walking away from there. It's creeping me out anyway. Let's try that key on the fucking weirdo door. No? Okay, I didn't think so. How about here? Wait, this was locked? Okay. We have found where that key unlocks. Alright. A troll. Thought for a second they misspelled towel. I don't know. Guys, I'm not very versed on gardenology. That's probably the term. That's like probably a term for small shovel. Alright. Okay, so whole lot of nothing. If they're not gonna let me read it. Alright. So I got like a digging thing. So let's go outside and see if there's anywhere that I missed that might look like I can dig in. Because usually when we're talking about digging, talk about outside. Where to dig, where to dig. Oh, okay. This looks like it might be promising. Let's give it a whirl. Oh! Why am I digging up bodies? Why are you digging up bodies? The legs and segmented underbelly of a cockroach. We're getting into some eldritch shit out here, man. Oh, a knife. Can I? Yes, let's go. I want that. I want the knife. So we're getting on some weird shit. Glad I found a use for that shovel, but not real glad at what I found. So I have a knife. I don't know what good that'll do me. But, let's try it on that door again, I guess? Oh, wrong one. Let's see if we can make an offering to the eternal damned soul that's rotting in cell 33. Maybe he won't kill me if I give him something he likes. Although, honestly, giving him a fucking knife is the last thing I want to do. Okay, I didn't think so. That looks like the final thing of the game. Go in there after I've done everything else. Alright, let's go find a use for that knife. Locked. Did I check this one out? Alright, okay. I don't know if I want to go through all these just to check if the knife does anything. But you know, I might as well. Gotta be thorough with these things. At least I found a way to do it faster. Okay, just as I thought. Nothing involved. Alright. Okay. So I've been in there, and... Oh no, okay, that's locked. Alright, let's keep going. Can I jam this door open? Okay. Well, I can't hear it, so that's fine by me. I think I've been in here. Yeah, that's outside. Alright, if none of these doors work, I'm gonna go outside and try to stab Mother Teresa in the boobs. See if that does anything. Oh, wait. Haven't been in here yet. But can I drink? That'd certainly make things easier to bear. Oh, okay, so now we got two knives. Pretty useless unless I can dual wield them, but you know, I'll take what I can get. Okay. Oh, all right, well, I got a key. Little bastard. Infirmary. Okay, let's see what this note has to say for me. Alright. It's the order list. One thing's for sure, these guys knew how to eat. Maybe that's why no one's there. How long can you survive while eating mealworm for breakfast? Alright. Well, since we got a key, let's try some more of those locked doors. Wait. Oh, this must have been one. Okay. Alright. I think I'm beginning to see something come together here. Why they got creepy-ass mutant bugs in the kitchen? Oh. I think I'm beginning to get an inkling of what might be behind door X. Oh, Jesus. So these guys are on the grind here, writing their thesis about some fucking creepy-ass bug monster. Oh, my lord. Okay. Alright, yes sir. Let's, see if there's anything with these books, and then if not, mosey our way on down to some more of those locked doors, see if we can unearth some more mysteries of this creepy-ass place. Okay. Had to make sure my audio was picking up from this thing. It's just a quiet game. Oh, and I hope the keyboard sound isn't too bad for you guys. I put the mic all the way up here to try to reduce it. It's the only thing I could do. There's not really a good way to dampen keyboard sounds without also messing with the quality of the... Hello? Well, I don't know where that came from, but it sounded close, so let's, Oh. Okay. This isn't looking good. Although, there's some cool drawings up here. Sounds like this place was doing some weird experimentation. Let's... Oh, yeah, I daren't. Yes, that's right. Collect as many knives as you can, buddy. You never know when you might need them. Okay, atmosphere is getting a little thick, a little oppressive. Let's check the rest of these doors. I'm having a hard time remembering how many I've unlocked, or what my inventory is. Alright, so that's locked, so I think that's the last one, because this is the bedroom, correct? Yes, okay. I believe that may be the last locked door. Let's check around, though, real quick, just to be sure. My memories, I'm all concentrated on this creepy shit. I can't remember where I've been and where I haven't. Okay. That's outside. Let me go back over here. I think this is just one loop, so I think I've seen everything there is to see. Yep, been in there. So all that's left... Been in there. All that's left is exploring more outside. Other than that, I can't think of anything. Yep, that's where it was earlier. Okay, let's go back outside. Mother Teresa, you all right there? No. Okay, so there's nothing more to interact with here. No hidden keyholes or anything. I think the graveyard was on the other side. Ah, the turn speed is agonizing. Agonizing, I tell you. I think it's actually slower than Doom's turn speed without sprint. Okay. I like the sky. The sky sets the mood. Alright. Well, let's go back in then and see if we can find anything we've missed. Okay, guys, I figured it out. It's something completely obvious, something I just overlooked, so bear with me here. It's pretty dark in there. It's kind of hard to see things. So anyway, back to the horror while I find this last key. So I believe it was in one of the side rooms. Let's try a few. I don't know how I do it, man. There's some kind of shortcut. There's some kind of shortcut, and I don't know what it is. All right. Hey, first try. All right, this is the room. And that's what I missed. That's what I missed. I didn't watch past this. I just wanted to see where I found the last key. Okay. So this is some creepy-ass bug fantasy here. Whoever was in this place is trying to turn people into those creepy incubator things that were fleshy things that I saw hanging off the ceiling in that one room. So that is the final key. Alright, are you guys ready? Let's go to the library. I believe it's either this place or the other one. Is this it? Nope, it's the other side. Actually, I'm just gonna take a shortcut. Good thing about playing this map for so long is you start to get a hang of where things are at. Right? Maybe not. I might have to eat my words. Son of a... Yeah. Yeah, I think I'm just looping all the way around. I thought it was... one of these areas on one side and one on the other, but I guess that's not the case. And I think this was just the one I was at. Yep. Okay, so instead of going through here this time like I know what I'm doing, I should surrender to being lost, give in to the confusion. Yeah, see, it's right here. This is the door. Give in to the confusion. Yield not to your light. Darkness is your new master. Okay. What is the rate of initiation for the hive? I mean, if we're following what that book text said, it sounds like it's drinking this bitch's bile and blood to soothe her seething anger. Oof. Well, the sky is pretty red out there. I think it's already begun, guys. Sorry to tell that to you, homeboy, but... Alright. Oh, one more piece of paper. Okay. Now that I have explored all of the rooms, I believe I can go to the creepy door now. So let's go ahead and see if that works. Because if it doesn't, I completely don't know what to do. Oh, for fuck's sake, bro. I got the last key. All of the doors are unlocked. Are there even more unlocked doors? What else am I missing? I gotta be missing something. There's gotta be something I haven't done yet. Maybe we visit the creepy statue out here? Get her blessing? No? Sheesh. Goodness, man. This is just one giant warping maze. But there's gotta be something I missed. I mean, okay, I've searched every room thoroughly, except for the library, which was the last one I just discovered. So I'm gonna scour it again. And then if not, after that, I'm gonna check this room, because I think that's the second one I haven't seen as much. Okay, read that note. The first thing that I missed in here was a book. The one down here. I actually clicked it, but I didn't click the right spot. So, that's got a bunch of passages, but nothing really that gets me anywhere. None here. None here. This is all nothing. What? Wow. That was totally noticeable. Oh my god. Okay, I guess there's sort of a cue. Like, these are back farther than these. But wow, really? That's what I was missing? Okay. So what do we have here? There. Now we got all the knives. I thought I had three already, but, you know, fool me once. I guess one of them was a scalpel. I see. The scalpel was just used to cut that bug apart. This knife is going to be used in the keyhole. Alright. Now I'm sure of it. There's nothing else. This is it. Okay. Let's enter the creepy room. Ooh. Okay. So, looks like this room's purple. It's got some purple flames over here. That's what's keeping the room alight. God, it just keeps getting louder. I'm a bit scared. If anything starts coming at me, I'm gonna turn around and run. Okay. Okay, so we're in an outside open area. The buzzing won't stop. It sounds like bugs, like locusts. Ooh, I don't like that. It feels like they're inside my head. Yeah, that's what it sounds. It's kind of filling up all my headphones. What's going on here, man? Oh no! I've been transformed! What's that? Who are you? What? That was it! Holy crap. I expected some kind of monster to get out and chase me. But I'm a bit more happy with that ending. Jesus Christ. Damn, so it looks like the gist of that story is these guys are like experimenting with eugenics or whatever. They're trying to create some winged insect being based on the corpses I dug up and those sack things hanging in one of the rooms, and they succeeded. I guess that was me. Or I might be getting the story wrong. That's what I picked up from the context clues, though. Man, that was pretty creepy. The atmosphere was good. The graphics really sold it. I mean, obviously not like platinum 5-star graphics, but I'll take it over something that looks really polished. There's something about that gritty PS1 feel that just makes horror games all that more appealing to me. So man, if that's one of her games, that one took me about 25 minutes, maybe a little more to complete. There's a lot of wandering that I'm going to cut out because that doesn't serve anything. So if you see any jump cuts, you know why. But yeah, that was the first out of like 15, 17 games she's made. And I mean, these are just the Haunted City series. So we've still got a million of these we could play. But I gotta say, I really like her style. I found out about her video games through a YouTube video called 4 Short Games About Pain. I can't quite remember who did it. It was either Solar Sands or 4 Shorty Games About Pain. Yeah, Jacob Geller, that's the dude. But yeah, I thought that it really struck me, and I looked in her catalog and picked one that I thought would be cool for you guys. So anyway, I hope you guys liked it. Hopefully next time there'll be a lot less wandering, and I can figure out where the hell I'm going. But anyway, I'm in the middle of creating another Doomwise video, but I might record another Indie Closet, seeing as I've got a wealth of content. But you guys can expect some more videos from me soon. I know it's been, as I said earlier, I know it's been a while, but I hope not to fall off like I did last time. Because honestly, creating stuff, I love it. I love making videos. I do it for me, also for you guys, but it's an activity I can do that just makes me feel good. That I have something to look back on later, like actual proof of my work. So I assure you it's not because I don't love it. So hopefully later I can make some more videos and wrap all these things up. My life's looking better, so hoping things will be going smooth from now on. So anyway guys, really appreciate you watching. Drop a like if you want, drop a comment if you got anything to say about it. And I will see you guys next time, alright? So stick around and have a good one. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Keep my business off the ground. Switch my style like I switch hands. Going to war in foreign land. Fuck out the way, bitch, back it up. Shit better get played in the palace.